Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. In this video, we're going to look at which flap setting to use for your approaches. So let's jump straight in. Before we do that, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and give the video a like. So, which setting do we use? In the real world, my operator prefers pilots to use flaps config free because there's a fuel saving associated with that. With less flap out, there's less drag, and therefore we can save sometimes up to 50 kilograms on approach. So if you multiply that by every aircraft in the fleet, which is quite a large fleet, there's a big saving there. So that's kind of our default, but there's other things we need to consider as pilots as well. So flaps full gives us the greatest lift at least speed, so that minimizes our landing distance, so we need to consider landing runway length. In flaps free, we come in slightly faster because we have less lift than at flaps full, so we need greater speed. Flaps free is not preferable for a short runway. You also need to consider the impact on our brakes, so may potentially have to use more braking action, especially if the runway is reasonably short. So we need to consider our turnaround times, and have we got time for our brakes to cool on the turnaround? That's a consideration. Flaps free with that reduction in lift is also not preferable on a tailwind. So any kind of tailwind component, we generally go flaps full. And that's because we have that slightly less lift, and a tailwind reduces our lift further. So we opt for flaps full in that scenario. You also want to think about your approach angle, so your glide path angle. So have a look at your charts. Are you on a standard 3-degree glide slope, or is it greater than that? If it's greater, the benefit of the drag of flaps full will allow the aircraft to decelerate on the approach. So that's preferable. You will struggle to slow the Airbus down, and particularly Airbus A319, if you're on flaps free and quite a high glide path angle. Remember to select your flap setting in your performance approach page. So today we're going to use config free. We select that, and we also want to make sure on the overhead we select landing flaps free to stop the system alerting us to a potential incorrect flap setting. Another thing to consider is our pitch. So with a flaps free landing, we're slightly faster, and therefore our pitch is slightly higher. If I select flaps full now, you will see the nose drop. So I've selected flaps full and the nose begins to drop. So if we're in a low visibility landing and we're keeping a sharp eye out for approach lights, for example, in fog, flaps full is generally the way to go because it gives us a greater visual picture of the runway ahead of us, or the approach lights, or whatever it is we're trying to look for. So consider the visual picture. I go back to flaps free now, and the nose will begin to rise again. And this is also a consideration for our landing flare. So remember, flaps free, the attitude of the aircraft is already higher than a flaps full, and therefore less back pressure is required on the side stick in the flare. So a common mistake would be that pilots overflare the aircraft in flaps config free, and therefore risk a tail strike. But in wind shear, the tail strike is a bigger consideration. So we want to avoid flaps config free in wind shear scenarios. So that's another consideration. Generally, the aircraft performs better in turbulence in flaps config full. So if you've got really turbulent conditions, consider config full. The Airbus tends to ride out the turbulence better in that configuration. So one final approach here to London Luton's runway 25 in config free. remember in config 3 not to overflare. First, spoilers, peace out. Manual braking, 30 knots. Up brake set, so let's just recap on that. So, there's obviously a bit to take in there. The config 3, certainly for my operator, was a default, and that's the same for many operators around the globe. Just that fuel saving and the beneficial environmental impact. The big factor really is landing distance. If we've got a nice long runway, flaps 3 is definitely preferred. If we have a tailwind, flaps config full. If we have a lot of heavy turbulence, flaps config full, from my piloting experience, is better in the Airbus. The aircraft's a little bit more stable in that turbulence. If you're on a cat-free autoland and you're looking out for those runway lights, consider that visual picture. Flaps full is preferred in that scenario because it gives us greater visibility outside of the aircraft, allowing us to see those approach lights a little bit earlier. Don't forget to remember that change in visual picture, so always remind yourself which flap setting you're using, thinking about your pitch, particularly in the flare as well. And then there's the glide slope angle. That's a big consideration. Having the extra drag of flaps config full on a steep approach is really helpful, and as I said before, particularly in the A319, you will struggle to slow that aircraft down if you're not in flaps full configuration. Don't forget to set the correct configuration up in the approach page of your MCDUs, and also hit that GPWS landing flaps free button on the overhead if you're using flaps config free. If you have any questions on that at all, please drop them in the comments box below and I'll do my best to answer those. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button to stay up to date with the latest content, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.